Thank you. The song we just sang for you is one with many layers of history and meaning. Its music comes from the songs Wildflowers by Tom Petty and Hard Times Come Again No More by Stephen Foster. Hard Times Come Again No More and a cover of Wildflowers by the bluegrass trio Waylon Jennings then inspired Dr. Amanda Quist and her husband Tim Brent to create an arrangement that combined both songs and dedicated to their four-year-old son, Alex. This arrangement of Wildflowers was premiered in Carnegie Hall on March 20th of this year, where 31 of our students from Chamber and Show Choir joined 8 other choirs from around the country to sing together. We then brought back our experience, memories, and lessons from Carnegie Hall to share with all of our fellow choir students here, and now we'll share it with you. This song is special to many of us, not only because we had the incredible opportunity to perform it in Carnegie Hall, but also because of its powerful meaning, as many of our friends and classmates are graduating or moving away. We sing to them, sad that they must sail away, but we know that the song will linger forever in our ears, a memory of our special times as a choir and as a family.
Did you know that Bach is super cool? While our next piece, O Charlotte, may be one of the more challenging songs we've had to learn, it's also turned out to be one of the most rewarding. The complex layering of the different voice parts together with the piano creates a most satisfying musical puzzle for the ears. We hope that by leading you in this waltz-like tune, you'll come to appreciate the master of counterpoint as much as we have. Enjoy!
Thank you. della mia vita is a modern rendition of a classical Italian song. Its lyrics translate to a beautiful poem about loving someone till they're old. As the separate voice parts glide into each other and the chords rise and fall, they really set the tone for romance and love. While learning the song, Mr. Police taught us that double consonants in Italian should represent a stutter of love. I especially love the song. Listen to this, especially in the ending line that translates to, and whether you follow me or flee me softly, you consume me.
Our song Si Trova Menes by Laura Jacobson is a beautiful Latvian ballad reflecting on the memories of time gone by too fast. Its dynamic contrasts, lyrics about good memories, and swooping notes that are reminiscent of cries and wails adds to the feeling of loss. The singer expresses in the music and the lyrics that they long to go back to those days when their loved one was still with them, before they had lost a piece of themselves. Haunting and stricken with grief, Si Trova Menes perfectly captures the feeling of heartbreak and helplessness after losing a pet. Please enjoy our performance of Si Trova Menes.
Here far This song we just sang, this upcoming song is the arrangement of I've Been Working on the Railroad, unlike any you've heard before. Most likely because it was arranged by Chamber Choir's very own, the incredible Calvin Shaw. When we all saw this piece, I think our first feeling was something of fear. The time signature changes frequently between 6-8, 9-8, 12-8, and 15-8. Which, if you don't know about music, your reaction is most likely, what? And if you do know music, your reaction is more likely, why? Nevertheless, after we got into it, it quickly became the most fun song and has been my personal favorite to perform. We premiered this song at the Golden State Choral Competition, where Calvin received an award for his amazing compositional skills. I have personally had the great honor to work on several projects with Calvin, seeing his compositions, and I'm always glad to hear, and this time have the opportunity to sing more of his music. Performing this piece has truly been an incredible experience and has been one of my favorite parts of getting to join Chamber Choir this trimester. Well, it seems just about time for the whistle to start blowing and for this song to chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga its way into your heart. I truly hope you enjoy this song all the live long day.
It's written by Erica Lloyd and arranged by Vince Peterson. It's my personal favorite that we will be singing. Cell's Planets reminds me of love. The love you can feel all around you, but you can't see. The lyrics, I don't know you, but I like you. I don't know you, but I miss you. I don't know you, but I need you, to me represent the moment of realization. Realizing how much you love and appreciate someone or something, but aren't exactly sure what that thing is. You find yourself searching for that feeling, trying to label it, but you can't. Nonetheless, you know it's there. When I sing Cell's Planets, it makes me feel as I'm ascending into space. Yet at the same time, I also feel so grounded and connected to the people around me. This song represents the peace I feel while singing with others. It reminds us that we are all just tiny pieces of a galaxy and that the world is so much bigger than you and me. Please enjoy Cell's Planets.
Thank you. Everyone, while we switch over from chamber to concert choir, I just have a few quick announcements. Last year, we had a really exciting project which involved several of these students. We had a bunch of students write their own original musical. So Calvin Schaller and Dorothy Catapon were both in that creative team, and many of the students here, and I saw many of you here tonight, that came back, which is so cool. Last year we made a cast album of that, and it's coming out next week. So by next weekend, on all of your favorite streaming services, you can find the cast album for Insert Future here. So look for that next weekend after graduation, and we're really excited to share that with you. One other small announcement is that you'll find some dates for next year in the program, so make sure you look, it's like so weird to think about next year, but look in at, get those dates on your calendar and look at the district calendar, which is also posted for next year as well. So here we go with concert.
Song is Do Maybe. This song is a lullaby and folk song sung in Medina, which is a Judeo-Spanish Roman language of Sephardic Jews. This Medina was a language that not many people speak anymore, so it's been an amazing experience to hear the pronunciation and the meanings of these words. It's a lullaby where a mother is singing to her son, Dudme Dudme, Ishiko Demarme, which translates to sleep, sleep, mother's little boy. When learning the song, we use words from the song's direct translation to express the emotions of the different parts of the song. Some of these words include beauty, worry, joy, and sleep. We also learned to let ourselves crescendo and decrescendo when we truly felt like we should. In doing that, we added even more emotion to this piece. This song is full of sentimentality and power. We hope you enjoy. Do it by doing it.
Thank you.
class spent a lot of time learning about the traditional roots and history of the Filipino folk song, Seafood of Man. We learned about its key changes and understanding that a song can never be more authentic than another. Discovering and singing this song has brought me the biggest and deepest longing to understand more about my Filipino culture and music. Somehow, it has brought my parents and me closer together, bonding over a song that they sustained when they were young and that I grew up singing. This song has many different versions due to the vast variety of dialects that come from the Philippines. But today, we'll all be singing the Visayan version. We hope you enjoy it.
Wise in Hearts is a song about seeing someone with great sadness or despair. This person is not able to express in words how they are feeling, but their presence alone indicates that they are in need of help. This song is by two very talented students in choir, B. Acevedo and Calvin Schaller. Concert Choir gets the honor of premiering this song tonight. Bea and Calvin are very inspiring to me, and as a student in my first year of choir, I look up to them. We hope you enjoy.
Scary.
Please Come Fly With Me was composed by Sammy Hahn and James Van Heusen. This song was first recorded by Frank Sinatra in 1957 and has since then become a beloved classic of the American music. During these past few weeks, we've had a blast learning about different vocal jazz techniques, such as swinging, sliding, and scatting. So, whether you're floating down to Peru or taking off in the blue, the jazzy and upbeat tempo of this arrangement is sure to be the perfect accompaniment to any jam.
Come fly with me, let's fly, let's fly. Look at that. Let's do that.
Just while we wait for Schulhart to come on stage and continue the program, I do want to take a moment to celebrate our beloved Miss Hovey, who's retiring this year. Carol Hovey, if you're one of her former students. She's been teaching here for 38 years, so there are parents of children in this program who had Miss Hovey when they went to the Moore High School. She's having an open house to celebrate her retirement on Saturday, June 10th, and there's actually a flyer on the door over there, on the theater door, that you can see with some more details. But it would be really fun if you could come out and celebrate Miss Hovey or her retirement.
A Wink and a Smile is a classic barbershop song arranged by Ken Britton, with choreo made by our very own Annabella Piazza and Andre Wickerlaw. Full of slides and energy, yet there is something more to this song, something that makes it my favorite in our repertoire. A Wink and a Smile is a love song, all about thinking back on those first magical moments you shared with someone you love. I hope this song can remind you of a first love that you had or still have today. With that, let's go on with a wink and a smile.
Come What May is incredibly special because of the way we all plan the specific phrasings and articulations throughout the whole song to support the emotional flux and flow. If you listen specifically for the part where we sing the words, "Listen to my heart, can you hear it sing?" you might notice that the whole section is faster than before, but the tempo is steady at its faster rate. This was a direct result of the whole class's collaboration, because there were so many different opinions on how that specific section should be sung, and we all eventually agreed on this one. In this way, the rehearsal process of this song, as well as the final presentation to all of you, works as a collective celebration of the collaborative nature of music. Let's wrap up our barbershop adventure by traveling down the Seven Bridges Road. This Eagles song may be one you can recognize with Steve Young's joyful words and music. Our arrangement was crafted by Jeremy Johnson, and with our hint of flair, you may just want to sing along. You can, quietly. This song also enjoys long pauses, and if ever you decide you should clap, you can visualize yourself clapping and save the real applause for the end. I hope you can come and enjoy our travels with us down the Seven Bridges Road.
Green lights and all rides, let's go.
Together.
Here we go with a wink and a smile. Southward as you go. Say if I've been changed. So, everyone else, if you come on stage, just get on the stage. Get on the stage. But everyone. So, in a moment, we're going to take some time to recognize our graduating seniors. This class has been really, really special to me, and very sad to see them go. So before we do all like the crying and stuff, let's do like the boring part. So first, I just want to say a quick thank you to all of our volunteers who helped us out tonight. So we had Katrina upstairs, and we had Val and Ms. Cortina donations at the door. We also had one of our math teachers, Mr. Girardi, along with Jen Moy, helping out backstage tonight. So we're going to give them all a big round of applause. Another moment to recognize our amazing, wonderful accompanist, Christina Vankenberg. I'd also like to take a moment just to thank any members of our admin team or school board who are here tonight. So if you're an admin member or school board member, will you wave your hand? Yay! Thank you. We're really, really grateful to have a school board and a site administration that continues to make decisions that allow this to happen and allow it to continue to happen in the future. So we're very grateful for all of those people. Okay, so now before we get to the fun part, this is the really boring part, which is, speaking of volunteers, all of you can volunteer tonight. Michelle Bratz, are you here? Will you wait? Okay, so Michelle Bratz and the whole Bratz family are fabulous. I've taught so many of their children, and they also are super involved with one of our amazing local dance companies, and they have a littles show tomorrow. Little tiny babies dancing on the stage, and so they're loading in their dance floor tonight. So we have to get everything off the stage as soon as the concert's done. So if you're feeling ready to help and able-bodied, if you could come to the stage at the end and we can get the risers and the sound shell and the piano all put away. Lisa Britton, will you wave? Lisa down here has been our teardown coordinator for like the last 4 years, and so she's wearing a cream-colored cardigan, and she knows how to safely operate the risers and the shells so that no one gets injured while we put this away. So if you want to help out, please come to the stage at the end, and Lisa is in charge, and so is Emma, because those go together. So without further ado, we're going to take some time to thank our seniors who are graduating. We do this. In order of the number of trimesters that someone has taken choir. One thing I think that's really cool is we get seniors who decide that they want to do choir as a senior and then discover they love it, And we also have students who take choir for 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, which Ryan is as well there in high school. So we're going to recognize them in that order. I'll read a group of seniors all at the same time who are sort of in the same bracket, and then we can go through that. So the following students are in that super special group that have completed 1 to 3 trimesters. That means most of these students decided as 17 or 18 year olds, choir is for me. And then they found a place here with us. So this is Athena Nelson, Evelyn Lewis. So Athena Nelson, Evelyn Lewis, Rick Prabhakar, Cherish Nunez, Alina Kvashian, and Sofina Salvatore. Go on to the next group. The seniors pretty much know what's going on, but these bags have notes from everyone in choir, that some of which are specific and meant for you specifically, seniors, and some are just meant to like help you go on to your next chapter in life. So I hope you enjoy reading those. There's also a note from me there, and then the thing in the basket is a pin that you need to wear at graduation. So don't lose it between now and graduation. Okay. Our next group of seniors has taken 4 to 6 trimesters of choir. Several of these students are actually really involved in our instrumental program and then found a way to make both choir and instrumental music happen, which we really appreciate. So we'll do this whole big group. This is Calvin Schaller, Amira Sain, Alice Peruso, Daniel Brown, Anna Tang, B. Azevedo, and Emily Butler. To the real super extra choir territory. The following students have taken 7 to 11 trimesters of choir, so that means they've been in choir 3 or 4 years in high school. This is Hershey Sarabi, Tanisha Dega, DJ Humes, Jennifer Valdez Vargas, Audrey Fig Furlot, Lillian Engelsjeard, Vanessa Morales, Natalie Alum, and Emma Britton. Our last group. So these are students who have taken 12 or more trimesters of choir. So that means either they were enrolled in choir every single trimester of high school, or if they missed one, then they took 2 at the same time at some point. So actually, this first group is 12 to 14 trimesters, okay? So this is Alexa Hart, Dorothy Catapon, Claire Johnston, Rhiannon San Miguel, and Ernest Bell. More, and I'll recognize them individually if that's okay. The first is a student who took a total of 17 trimesters of choir and is currently in three of his 4 periods, since he doesn't even take all 5. So this is with 17 trimesters, Bryce Moy. That I want to just take a moment to especially recognize is also the winner of this year's Vocal Music Award at the Senior Awards Night, which took place earlier this week. Kathy Sneddon has been really incredible, not only in chamber choir for the last few years, but also as a member of concert choir. So she's a senior who decided she just wanted to take the non-audition choir again so she could be a student leader. And she's really shown herself to be a really positive peer role model. So Kathy, make sure there's a separate pin for you. So it says choir. So make sure you get it.
Hello, Emma. I'm going to keep this short and simple because Felice is really humble and hates people talking about him and the attention and being on him. I would just like to say that Felice has been such an amazing teacher to all of us on stage and maybe some of us in the audience. I'm going to try not to cry. I'm sorry if I do. Please don't leave me if I do. It's tradition for the seniors to always give Mr. Felice a gift as a going away gift. And so this year, because you love dog calendars, we made you a calendar. Don't read it now, otherwise you're really, really going to cry. But yeah, round of applause for Mr. Felice.
Bridge Over Troubled Water is a song that we sing at the end of every year. It's the song that is forever imprinted onto LHS Choir Sweet Springs, even after we graduate. We view it as a send-off to the seniors to say, we are here to support you as you go on your way. Being a senior myself, this message is very special to me. However, this year, the song has a double meaning as we say goodbye to our beloved choir director, Mr. Felice. We don't know what the future will bring. The performing arts program at LHS is going through a lot of changes this year. Still, we know that good or bad, the choir family that Felice has helped create at LHS will be there for each other, like a bridge over troubled water.
Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down.
Thank you.